All right, Jonathan Graves once again reporting to you live from Dixie. We're taking this show on the road for this week. And I'm standing here with the Dixie coach. And he's about to tell you his name and a little bit of background information about himself.
Well, Steve Dunlap. I've been softball coach at Dixie for 11 years. We've had a lot of success the past few years. We've been fortunate, had a lot of good athletes come through. And this year was a challenge for us. We lost three players to graduation last year, so we had to deal with some inexperience issues. But our young lady stepped up and did quite a good job for us.
Coach, coming into the region, play is a little bit of a slow start. I know you lost that first game at home in 9-6. What were you telling the girls after that game?
Well, I just said, you know, by losing that game to 96, it just made our situation tougher. Fortunately, Ware Scholes helped us out by defeating 96. Had we won out, it would probably force a playoff situation between us and 96 in first place. With Ware Scholes a big gift, we were fortunate enough not to have that situation.
Now, this is y'all's sixth consecutive region championship, am I right?
That's correct.
Okay, what makes this one more special than, let's say, the other five?
This year, it's been more of a team effort. Everybody's contributed. One of the disappointing things we had this season, however, was it seemed that a lot of times we would play to the level of our competition. We would play just good enough to win. I tried to get them all year to get more of a killer instinct, to get some fire in their eyes, to really come out and be aggressive. I think here with the 96 game, they really came together in that game, and they've stayed up the entire game, and they did a good job for us.
How are you looking into the future right now? You got only one senior on the team, so pretty much your whole team's coming back. Are you kind of looking at another region championship next year?
Well, we certainly hope so. That's in our plans. We do feel good about having eight starters returning, and we have a few good athletes that we can pull up from our JV team. Our JV coach does an excellent job with them, getting prepared for varsity play, and we feel good about our chances for next year.
Now, going into the playoffs, I know you know you're going to have most of the playoff games right here on this field. How are you looking at that, some of the teams, some of the competition in the district that you're taking a look at?
Well, when you get this time of the year, all the competition is going to be tough. We're playing Christchurch tomorrow. They're from Region 2. I don't really know that much about them, but we played them in the first round last year, and we're fortunate enough to defeat them.
Right.
Also in this district, we have Buford, who is from Region 3. And Buford and all the teams in Region 3 are tough. They've got a lot of travel ball players in that region, girls that play softball year-round. That added experience and confidence they get from doing that makes them a tough region. Also in our district, we have Williston Elko that we were fortunate enough to beat last year. We're going to try to go on some of the notes that we've had from last year and see how it applies to the teams we face this year.
All right, my last question is, given that this is a double elimination playoffs, talk about the importance of even after getting that first loss, keeping your team on those high spirits and making sure they still playing the game the right way.
Well, what we've been preaching to the girls is you need to keep winning, because the longer you win, the longer you get to play at home. And with a couple of schools in our district, if we have to go on the road, we're looking at maybe 3 or 4 hour trips. And you know, you go through a trip like that and turn around and play a game, it takes a lot out of you. So it's really important to get those wins and stay at home and play as long as you can.
Coach, I appreciate the time.
Thank you very much.
Steve Dunlap, the coach of the Dixie softball Lady Hornets, and we're standing here at the Dixie field. Tomorrow they're going to play Christchurch right here on this field at 5:30. I'm Jonathan.
5 o'clock.
5 o'clock. And I'm Jonathan Gray. I'm a Greenwood Today reporter, and I'm reporting live once again from Dixie Field. I'm out.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right.